Hello and welcome back to Something Z, and welcome to If Naruto Had the Two Tails Part 2. Last time on the What If, Naruto was able to pass the Genin test, and he, Sasuke, and Sakura became Team 7, with their team leader being Kakashi. And after a while, they get sent on a mission they assumed was a C-rank mission, but after they got attacked by a couple of shinobi, they find out that the mission was mislabeled, and it was actually higher. But even with this knowledge, they continued on with the mission, and eventually after some walking, they come across a shinobi by the name of Zabuza, and he and Kakashi fight. But before the fight could actually end, he gets killed by shinobi with a mask, and he gets taken away. Then after the fight, Kakashi was taken to the bridge builder's house to rest. Okay, so now that's out of the way, let's jump into the video in 3, 2, 1. Okay, so we begin this what if a couple of days after the fight between Kakashi and Zabuza, and Kakashi just woke up. And when he woke up, he found himself in a room he didn't recognize, and seeing this, he began to get up. But before he could actually get to his feet, he gets pushed back to the ground by a woman who just walked into the room, and she told him that he was brought to Tazuna's house after he got knocked out by his teammates. And hearing this, Kakashi calmed down and went back to sleep. And a couple of days later, Kakashi was healed enough to get back up and stand with the help of crutches. And when he got up, he got his three genin and he brought them into the nearby woods. And when they were far enough, he told them that they will be learning how to walk on vertical surfaces by walking up the nearby trees. And when the genin did it for the first time, Sasuke and Naruto had trouble doing just a couple of steps, but Sakura was able to walk up the tree completely without any problems. So the two continued to train all day trying to walk up their respective trees while Sakura went to the store with Tazuna. But before Sakura left with Tazuna, she gave Naruto some advice to walk up the tree, which did help him somewhat. And by the end of the day, Naruto and Sasuke haven't mastered walking up vertical surfaces, but now they have a decent grasp on it. And while Team 7 was eating dinner at Tazuna's house, they learned about Inari's stepfather and why he doesn't believe in heroes. And hearing about Inari's past, Naruto wanted to prove Inari wrong by showing him that there are still heroes in the world. So Naruto ran out of the house and he went into the nearby forest, and he began to train walking up trees, and he kept training until he passed out from exhaustion. And when he woke up, he saw someone standing above him, and when he recognized this, he shot out a mouse hairball at the person, but before he could hit, the person jumped out of the way, and when Naruto got up, he saw that the person was in a kimono, and since he didn't see any weapons, he believed that she was a normal townsperson, and in response, Naruto began to apologize to the person, who accepted it, and the two began to talk about why Naruto was passed out in the woods, and after some time, the person in the kimono told Naruto that he has to collect herbs, but right before he leaves, he tells Naruto that someone is only truly strong when they have something they want to protect, and once the person left, Sasuke appeared and he told Naruto that they should continue training, so the two then trained until it was night, and by the end of the day's training, they were both able to climb up their trees. And when they were done, they went to Tazuna's house for dinner. So now we skip to the next day, and when they were ready, Sasuke, Sakura, Kakashi, and Tazuna went to the bridge Tazuna was building. And they didn't bring Naruto since he was exhausted from using so much chakra in the past couple of days, and his body finally gave in. And when Naruto eventually woke up, it was hours after the group left. So Naruto then ran out of the house and he began to run to the bridge, as fast as he could through the woods. But after some time, Naruto noticed markings on the trees he's running past, so he stopped, and he notices that they are leaning back to where he came from, so Naruto then began to run back. So now we jump to the bridge, and currently most of Team 7 was watching Tazuna work, but after some time, the group knows Zabuza and the masked shinobi standing on the water in front of the bridge, and before they can do anything, Zabuza covered the area in a thick mist, and when the mist was completed, Zabuza jumped onto the bridge and he ran at Kakashi and they began to fight, while Sasuke began to fight the masked shinobi, and Sakura seeing this ran to Tazuna and she stood next to him to protect him. And after a couple of minutes of fighting on the bridge, Sasuke gets surrounded by ice mirrors. So now we jump back to Naruto, and he just got back to Tazuna's house, and the first thing he saw when he got back was Inari running at two thugs with weapons, and his mom was held hostage behind them. So Naruto quickly ran in front of Inari, and he made four Shao clones, and when they were formed, two ran behind the two thugs, and seeing this, the thug closest to Inari's mom went to slice her with his sword. But when he began to move his arm, the two Naruto seeing this shot out mice hairballs, which hit the thug's hand, which made the thug drop the weapon from pain. Then the Narutos began to fight the thugs, and with the help of their fire jutsus and the pure numbers they had, they were able to beat the thugs up, and when they were on the ground, one of the Narutos grabbed a nearby rope, and they began to tie the thugs up. And after the thugs were secure, Naruto undid the clones, and he began to run to the bridge again. And when Naruto got to the bridge, he saw Zabuza and Kakashi fighting, and Sakura was standing by the bridge builder to protect him. He also saw Sasuke surrounded by ice mirrors, and thinking that the other two could handle themselves, Naruto ran to Sasuke, and he tried to attack the mirrors from the outside by shooting out mice hairballs to hopefully melt the ice. But no matter how hot he made them, they wouldn't melt. So seeing that this wasn't working, Naruto ran inside the dome to see if it would work on the inside. And when he was inside, he was stuck having to avoid the ice needles with Sasuke, while still trying to find a way to melt the mirrors using his fire jutsus. But after some time, Naruto Naruto starts to pass out from him overusing his chakra. And when Naruto is flickering through consciousness, Haku flung a needle at Naruto that would have been a fatal hit. But before the needle hit, Sasuke jumped in front of it and it hit him instead. And when the needle hit, Naruto was able to wake up enough to process what was going on. And what he saw was Sasuke standing 1 second, then him collapsing the next. And seeing this, Naruto tried to shake him awake, but after a couple of shakes, it was obvious to him that he wouldn't wake up. And based on Sasuke not moving and the amount of blood that was coming from him, Naruto believed that Sasuke died from blood loss. And seeing that, Naruto only felt one thing, and that thing was rage. And with that rage, he was able to draw out some of the Two Tails' chakra. And seeing that he was doing it to avenge a friend, the Two Tails allows him to take her chakra. And after a couple of seconds of Naruto just staring at Sasuke's body, he gets surrounded by a mostly orange chakra, with some blue chakra mixed in. And the chakra didn't just give him back his chakra, but it made him change physically, and it made him stronger, with him now having one yellow and one green eye. And Naruto now has fangs and claws, and finally, his hair seemed to be engulfed in a blue flame, which didn't seem to burn him at all. And when he was sure he was done changing, Naruto, with the power of his chakra, was able to break the mirror Haku was in, which made him have to jump from ice mirror to ice mirror to avoid Naruto. And with the adrenaline Naruto had, he ran at Haku as fast as he could. And when he got to him, he punched Haku in the mask, launching him through an ice mirror, which shattered when he made contact. And when that mirror broke, all the other mirrors broke as well. And when Haku landed, Naruto ran at him, and he was about to deliver another punch to the face. But when he was about to make contact, the mask Haku was wearing came off, revealing the masked shinobi to be Haku. And seeing this, Naruto stops his attack, and he turns back to his original self. It's then that the two talk about Zabuza, and why he means the world to Haku. And by the end of the story, Haku asks if he's going to do what he started. And hearing this, Naruto nods and grabs a kunai from his bag. Then he went to stab Haku. But before the blade hit him, Haku blocked the blade, and he says he will not die to him. And in a blink of an eye, Haku disappears. And seeing Haku disappear, Naruto began to look around to see where Haku went. And eventually, after a couple of seconds, Naruto was able to find where Haku was. He was currently standing in between Kakashi and Zabuza, with Kakashi's hand inside of Haku's chest, and it was obvious that he was dead. And when Haku's body hit the ground, the fight between Zabuza and Kakashi continued, with Kakashi able to eventually restrain Zabuza, and in the process, he was able to break both of his arms, making Zabuza unable to wield his sword. And when his arms were broken, the mist Zabuza created began to dissipate, and eventually completely disappear. And when it was gone, Sakura was able to see Sasuke's unconscious body, so she ran to him, and she tried to wake him up. And a couple of minutes later, a group of people start to walk onto the bridge. And when the group looks at the new group, they see Gaara with a dozen of his goons. And when Gaara was a couple of feet away, he told Zabuza that he was fired, since he had failed him too many times. Then he kicked Haku's dead body, which infuriated Naruto. Not because of what Gaara did, it's because of what Zabuza did, since when he kicked him, he did nothing. So Naruto then began to shout at Zabuza, saying how much he meant to Haku. And eventually, Zabuza starts to cry, and he asks Kakashi to give him a kunai, which Kakashi agrees to, and he puts it into Zabuza's mouth. And when Zabuza was sure it was secured, he began to run at the group of thugs. And when he got to them, he began to slash at them, badly injuring or even killing some of them. And whenever Zabuza got stabbed or sliced, he would just keep going. And eventually, after around 10 people, Zabuza was able to get to Gaara, and he stabbed him in the gut with the kunai, and he pushed him off the edge of the bridge, which made him fall into the water below. And shortly after Gaara died, Sasuke woke back up, since he was able to gain enough chakra to wake up. And shortly after Sasuke wakes up, the bridge starts to get flooded from the people from the village, which scares away the rest of Gaara's group that Zabuza didn't kill. And a bit after the thugs left, Zabuza started to give in to the injuries he took, and he was about to die. So he asked Kakashi to bring him to Haku, which Kakashi agrees to. And shortly after he was placed next to Haku, he died. And because the person they were protecting Tazuna from was dead, the mission was over and labeled as a success. And once Sasuke got his wounds healed up, and he was able to rest, Team 7 went back to the Hidden Leaf. And it was from this mission that Naruto comes up with his ninja way. So now we skip to the day after Team 7 got back to the Hidden Leaf. And Naruto, after he was done with his missions for the day, went to train in the woods. And when Naruto was alone, he goes into the mindscape and he began to ask Metatabi what happened to him on the bridge. And it's then that he learns what happens when he uses the Two Tails' chakra, and how he can become even stronger if he can use it to the fullest. And because of the incident, the seal on Naruto has become weakened, so now he can harness more of the Two Tails' chakra. So Naruto then began to practice harnessing his new chakra, with him starting to get a good grasp a couple of days later. So now we skip a couple of days, and the third Hokage got all the team leaders, and he told them about the upcoming exams. And eventually, he asked what Kakashi, Asta, and Kurenai think about their genin, and if they actually believe that they are strong enough to take the Chunin exams, which they believe that their genin are strong enough to at least take the exams. Meanwhile, the same things were happening with Team 7. So Konohamaru was being held up by the collar by some foreign shinobi, and Naruto tried to run at him to try to save him, but before he was actually able to get to them, he tripped. And in the end, Konohamaru got saved by Sasuke, who was in a nearby tree. And before it could become an actual fight, another foreign shinobi appeared, and he apologized for his teammate's rudeness. Then the two walked away. So now we skip to the next morning, and Kakashi assembled Team 7, and it's there that they learned about the Chunin exams. And Sasuke and Naruto were on board the moment they heard about it, but Sakura, however, felt hesitant to take the exams. But after some convincing, she decided to take the exams as well. Then the meeting ended right after that. But right before they left, Kakashi told them that the test will be in about a week, and to meet them the day before, at the same place they are now so they can get more information. So now it's the day of the exam, and Naruto by this point is able to harness even more of the two-tailed chakra, so now he can be in the initial form for about 15 minutes, before he feels completely drained. So Team 7 just got to the exam site, but when they got to where they believed the exams were taking place, they saw that the hallway was full of examinees wanting to be let in into the exam room, and when they looked at the doorway, they saw two shinobi standing in the doorway, not letting anyone in. But after a minute of Team 7 waiting for something to happen, a fight starts to happen between someone in the doorway and an examinee. But before it can actually become anything, a guy with a bowl cut and a green jumpsuit stood in between the two, and he calmed them down, thus stopping the fight. Then the guy in the jumpsuit and Sasuke's eyes met, and when they did, the guy walked over to Sasuke and he challenged him to a fight, which at first Sasuke declined, so Naruto, wanting to test the guy's strengths, challenges him to a fight instead, which he accepted. So Team 7 and the guy walked to a nearby arena, and even with the help of the two tails, Naruto was still easily defeated by Lee. And seeing that Naruto was easily defeated, Sasuke walked over to Lee and he accepted his earlier challenge. But after a minute, Sasuke also got easily defeated by Lee, even though Sasuke was using his Sharingan. But before Lee could deliver the final blow, a puff of smoke appeared out of nowhere, and in the smoke appeared a turtle, which, to Team 7's surprise, makes Lee stop in his tracks. And when Lee lands, he runs to the turtle and he says he's sorry. But just then, another puff of smoke appeared on top of the turtle, and in that smoke appears a person that looks like a more grown-up version of Lee, who then in a matter of less than a minute, punches Lee for using a forbidden technique, and seeing this, Team 7 tried to leave, but before they could actually escape, the guy knows them and they began to talk, and through that they were able to learn that he was actually Kakashi's rival, and how he's supposedly physically stronger than him. Then after they were done talking for a bit, the two leave Team 7. The two leave the room, leaving Team 7 in there, and shortly after that, the three go to the exam hall. So now we skip to the actual exams, and everything we just skipped will be the exact as how it happened originally. So now all the Genin taking the exams went to a room filled with desks, and they were arranged in a way so they couldn't sit with their teammates. And when everyone was sitting down, the main instructor gets out of his seat and he stands in front of the room, and he tells everyone the rules of the exams. And when he was done explaining the rules, the examiners gave all the examinees the test, and by the end of the test, Naruto wasn't able to get a single question. And when the test was about to end, Hinata, who was sitting right next to him, allowed him to look at her sheet. But before he could actually get a good look, Naruto stopped in his place, because the moment he moved his head, someone behind him was caught cheating, and from that he got scared. So he told her that he was fine on his own, and that he could do it on his own. So a couple of minutes later, the main examiner got out of his seat, and he went to the front of the room. Then he told everyone that the test was now mostly over, but then he told them that there was actually a tense question. But before he actually says what the question is, he says that whoever fails this question will be permanently banned from taking the exams, and if one person gets it wrong, then the whole team fails. But then he continues by saying that there is a way out, and that if you don't want to take the question, you and your team will have to fail this exam, but you can return next year. And after around a minute, the people that wanted to leave left, and when the main examiner believes that they all left, he says that it's time for the final question. But instead of saying a question, he just says that they all passed, since the question was would they still try, even if it meant if you fail once, you fail forever. So now Team 7 has made it to the second phase of the exams, and this is where I'm going to leave What If. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you next time on Something Z.